Well, Willie Crow, this old Crow may be leaving before long.
What for?
Uncle Sam, he ain't doing so good with his fighting. Outside ain't. Sure look like they gonna call me up front there to help end all this ruction.
Well, go on, what's holding you back?
Oh, I don't know. I guess I must have diver's shoes on.
Well, them old suitcases? Boy, there ain't enough left of them shoes to hold you back.
Willie, you shouldn't talk that way about my shoes, because these is patent and leather shoes.
Patent and leather?
Yeah, leather on top and the bare feet patent on the ground.
Boy, you got the biggest and longest feet.
Oh, who?
Well, you. I bet you have to back up to knock on a door.
Oh, you Alabama owl, you. Don't you know there's a reason for my feet being big like this here?
Well, what reason?
Well, when I was a small boy, I used to work in the cotton fields that they fertilized with nitrates. And don't you know those nitrates just naturally developed my feet? And my Aunt Jane, she weighed 350 pounds, and Grandpa, he say maybe she must have sat down in the nitrates. What you know? Attention, Willie. There's the sergeant. Mobilize yourself.
Doggone, this must be the battleground. Look at all them holes in the pasture. Looks like the ground had a bad case of smallpox. What you reckon makes them, Amos?
Well, that's the way the frog farmers plow. Special kind of plow makes all them round holes.
Well, what took them to roast off of so many houses?
Boy, ain't your eyes got no connection with your brain at all? Ain't you notice how all the trees alongside the road is bent and busted? Means only one thing. They've had some kind of strong hurricane around here.
Amos, you know so much. What's that putt-putt-putt noise?
Why, that's the French whiffet bird.
Well, what's that zipping noise up above our heads like bees buzzing by?
Well, that's what it is, bees. And these here crazy frog bees work day and night, rain and shine, and don't accept leap year.
Hot dog, them bees got velocity. There goes my helmet.
Boy, brace yourself. Brace yourself. Here's what hit your helmet.
What is it?
Well, that's a bullet. That's what it is. And I'm going to find me a mess of safety.
Yeah, and then what are you going to do?
Then I'm going to read the rest of that book called Two Black Crows in the AEF, written by Charles Mack of Moran and Mack, the Two Black Crows, and published by Bob's Merrill Company of Indianapolis, Indiana. What you know?